Hey everyone, this is week 27, day 3. This is our spoken paintings week. So what we're trying to do this week is to describe a painting through the spoken word. And the hopes are that you guys, as you know, originally observers, now as listeners, can actually form an idea of what I am painting. So it's a really cool exercise. Again, like I said on Monday, just bear with me. This is just a week of this. It's a simple game. It's just a way to make, you know, painting more enjoyable. It doesn't have to be always about putting paint down, paint, but also about questioning, you know, the very nature of painting as a visual language. So I think this is a cool way of doing it, and we're doing it collectively. So if you guys want to participate, what you have to do is just pay attention to the manner in which I'm describing what I painted for today, and just, you know, try to reconstruct that painting in your head. Now, remember, the goal is not for you to be able to imagine the exact same painting I painted. I'm not gonna show the paintings on Saturday and you're gonna go like, oh my God, like I had it stroke for stroke, it's the same thing, like we're connected. If that happens, then forget it, like the world is gonna end because that's kind of freaky. That would be very cool, but it is freaky. So the hope is that, you know, we can compare notes and maybe we're super off and maybe this speaks about the way in which I can interpret my paintings and I verbalize my paintings. It speaks about the inability that I have to remember, you know, objectively what I did and how that memory is kind of tinted by just my own experience or the way I understand my painting or the way I view my painting. So maybe there's a disconnect between the way I speak about my painting and what I actually did. Hopefully not. I think that I'm very honest with who I am, and I understand myself as a painter, and I think I can see my paintings for what they are. But, you know, I'm not immune to that. Maybe I'm just, you know, exaggerating everything. Who knows? So we can actually compare notes, you know, in a very kind of virtual way by just, you know, unlocking these paintings at the end of the week, and see what you guys think about them. I was speaking with Danny, and what we can do, now you guys don't have to do this. Only, you know, the people that want to do this, you can totally do this, which is if you also want to try and reconstruct visually what you are imagining after I describe my painting, that would be killer. That would be awesome. That would be incredible. Because to have those images and then to put, you know, whatever I painted right next to them would be just amazing. So there is a hashtag. We can use hashtag spoken paintings, and I'm going to tell Danny to put it somewhere around here. And I could just gather all those paintings and then put them right next to the, or images. They could be a collage. They could be anything. Color pencil. They don't have to be paintings. They could just be a drawing even. But we can put that right next to the painting that I did in the end. And see what happens. I think that play would be super cool. But, you know, it's not necessary. If we just kind of imagine, if we do this exercise where we just imagine, you know, the painting and only to then confront that with, you know, the effort that I did in painting and see, you know, what the dynamics are, like how they relate to each other, that would be very, very cool. So that's in kind of intro, like a shortened intro of what we're trying to do this week. Let's go to the third painting. This is a painting. I do this from time to time, and it's, I hope it's not weird, somewhat voyeuristic, I guess. I started wrong, but this could be interpreted in the wrong way. But I love to take snapshots of stories of my friends in Instagram, because I actually love the way they present themselves. I think that is an awesome way in which you can learn about how that person wants to present themselves. And I like it. Instead of just me imposing, you know, my view onto how, you know, I'm going to represent you and onto how I want to depict you, you are actually letting me know how you want to represent yourself. And that's why I like them. It's not just about taking a snapshot of my little screen and then saying, oh, I have a great reference now. No, it's actually about you. You are empowered with this, machine, and you're saying, this is what I want you, the observer, to know about me. I want to show myself under this light. And I like that. I actually really, really like that. So I always have, whenever I'm just swiping through my stories, I always have like these moments where I'm like, oh, that's super cool, and I save it. And it doesn't have to be saved for, to become later on a painting. I don't think, I've been very, very outspoken about this. I don't think painting is dignifying in any way. I don't think because something is painted, it's elevated in some way. It's not. It's just a painting. It would be the same thing if I just saw that photo and I made you, into a donut, into a piece of bread. I don't know. It's just a thing. A painting is just a thing. And in itself, it doesn't say anything. It doesn't do anything. So it's not like, people just took these photos, and then it is my job through painting to make this just absolutely amazing. No, it's just a painting, that's all it is. Now, having said that, this particular image is of a fellow painter. Now, I say this because, and maybe you've noticed this, whenever I paint fellow painters, I feel like there's an unspoken agreement where we can do whatever the hell we want. And especially if I can sense that through their painting, they are being very, very open and they're very, very honest. I know that they're not going to be afraid of, whatever somebody else can do with an image of them through painting. That's how I would feel. I'm totally fine with people taking images of me. I think I'm the worst subject matter, but that's something different. But if somebody took an image of me and made something completely weird and off and distorted and just strange, I would be like, hell yeah, that's so cool. So it is an image of a fellow painter. It is an image that they posted of themselves, presenting themselves. And I loved it. I absolutely loved it. I was like, this is a perfect, perfect opportunity to paint him. It's also my way of saying I really respect you. It's not the one way of saying I really respect you. It's not like the people that I haven't painted I don't respect, but it is a way of saying, that you look incredibly cool. You are somebody who I think is just an incredible artist, and I just want to spend some time just looking at you, thinking about your work, thinking about how your work is affecting me. So I think in that sense, the both of us share that love for very subtle distortion, very, very subtle distortion. So I was like, yeah, I can do this while I'm painting it. But I also wanted to paint with very definitive strokes and with very, I didn't want that to be just about being expressive. I also wanted the color that I chose to be super, super important. So my color choices were also, I wouldn't say highly specific. I wouldn't say they are like a puzzle that you're piecing together and you can just see, you can discern every single piece. But I would say that my brushstrokes are individual and you can kind of dissect them. Again, this is not patchwork, but there is kind of like a sensible choice to each of those brushstrokes. The one thing that I loved, aside from his expression that is just glorious, he's got an incredibly, incredibly expressive face. The thing that I loved about it was that there was a yellowish, I probably exaggerated all the hues in there. So if I saw something as gray yellow, I'm probably interpreting as like very yellow, not super saturated yellow, because you guys know me, I'm not, that keen to oversaturate anything. But I saw that the background was somewhat yellower, and I saw that his skin tone was kind of pale, but also yellower too. And I was like, oh, I can kind of match these two. I can kind of have the background just kind of flood into his face. And then his nose was a little bit darker, which is awesome about noses. And it's a little bit darker, so it's not like he disappeared into the background, but there is this atmosphere that is affecting both background and the colors that I used in his portrait. And then suddenly it kind of grounds, it kind of lands in his nose that has a little bit more structure, and it's a little bit darker, and then has that kind of highlight on the nose that's on the bridge of the nose that is kind of curving. Every time I see somebody with a sort of curved nose, because they probably broke their nose when they were younger or something, oh my God, I break that nose into 100 pieces. So I love that. I love when something is askew, my sign of respect is to really exaggerate that. I love you for that. I love the humanity behind things that are not symmetrical. I love it. I have this passion for it. I'm enamored by it. I just love it. So if the mouth drops a little bit on one side, that to me is like, you know, nature at work, and I live for those moments. So this portrait has a lot of like those tiny little moments that are not about making something really structured and classical and symmetrical. They are just kind of like this little staircase. I mean, I'm exaggerating it a little bit, but it is about those kind of shapes not having like an axis that they share, and I love that. And one of the coolest things about this was that the background, that yellowish, you know, wall that I was describing in the back, it's kind of like a midtone. It's kind of like a grayer midtone. But then what comes to light is a little bit of the forearm, and it's a very light forearm, and it looked yellow. It looked like, you know, lemon yellow, like a light lemon yellow. And I was like, oh my God, this is so good. Like, I have to try and paint this, because all the control that I could, that I was working super hard to have with the background kind of flooding into the head, if I could, you know, really, really be measured with the values up there, then I could just hit that little bit of the forearm and have that just kind of bright yellow. When I first painted it, I was like, it's gonna be bright yellow. That's gonna be one stroke of yellow. And I'm so mad at myself that I don't have the courage to just say, I'm gonna put bright yellow and that's it, I'm done. No, I didn't have that courage. Like, I eventually started to model the arm a little bit, like the biceps a little bit. And so it has form. It actually speaks about it being an arm, and it is lighter, and it is kind of like a yellower hue. It has like some tiny little changes in hue also. But I wish I was a little bit kind of stronger minded to say that has to be yellow, just pure yellow. No, forget it. It feels yellow, so I have to paint it yellow. So I have to remind myself to just be stronger when I'm painting. So that's a good reminder. And there's this dark mass that's kind of covering his forearm. And then you can just see these little hints in the bottom of the painting. In the bottom of the painting, you can just see these little hints of the thumb and two fingers, index finger and middle finger. And I decided to paint them like a very gray purple, with then some tiny little marks, like kind of orange gray marks for the little wrinkles on the knuckles. So it's a very weird kind of ending to that story, but I loved it. I loved it because it was a face that is sort of disappearing. I mean, the head is modeled, so it has a light side and it has a shade. So it is modeled in the sense that you can see light and shade. It's not that it just kind of disappears into the background. It actually turns, but it is very congruous with the atmosphere that's going on behind, and then the forearm, which is just glorious, just a bit of light, this tiny little rectangle of light, not the forearm, the biceps. And then the forearm covered by this dark shape, and then you see these two little fingers, these two little purple fingers with this thumb that is a little more orange-gray. Just the end of the story, just down there. And it's a weird painting. It's just a gorgeous, you know, photo to paint from. And I just loved saying, oh, I can take my chances with this. Now, I'm frustrated because now that I'm describing it, I wish I took more chances because that's always what I want to do. Like, I want to exaggerate things and I want to take a ton of chances. And I mean, when you see the painting, you clearly can tell that I was having fun. I think that this was a really fun painting to paint. And it shows. I think it definitely shows in everything, in the way I distort, in the way just I change up the colors. It's not crazy, it's not confetti, but it is just me having fun. So I loved it, but I think I can push more. So that's the moral behind this painting. Just push more. Just, you know, gather some more courage and just, I have to push. More so when I see it, I'm able to see it and recognize it and say, dude, this moved you. Like, come on, say it, you know, 1,000%. Like, you know, scream it from, you know, your window. Open up your window and just scream from the top of your lungs what you want to say. So I think I held back a little bit, but you know, you learn. So that was the third painting for this week. Remember, what we're trying to do is take all these things that I just said and configure them in some way and make them not a painting. I mean, it's super cool if you're able to just take all those ideas in your head and just, you know, scribble something through color or paint, but you don't have to. But just if you can just imagine something, if you can just say, let me shut everything off and just start to have those gears of imagination turn and see what, you know, I can come up with, that would be so awesome. And if I could peek into your brain again, like I said, and compare that with what I just described, then that would be glorious. But anyways, that's third painting for this week. I'll see you tomorrow. Remember, this is all unedited because I'm trying to just make sense of things. So it would be so kind of lousy if I scripted it or if I if we're editing it. So this is just me rambling. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. And we'll see what that fourth painting, I was going to say looks like, but no. You know, you're gonna listen to that painting. I don't know what that means. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.